In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make a simple slideshow with a little program called 4K Slideshow Maker. Now, if you saw on my little widget here on my desktop, today is December the 18th, 2019. 1 week from today is Christmas. And if you're like me, you like to take a lot of pictures around Christmas time of family and friends. And it's sometimes you like to take those images and create a slideshow to put on YouTube, to share with your family and friends, to make a DVD or Blu-ray and play on your television set. So if you do, this is probably one of the simplest ones for creating slideshows out of your images. Now, if you found this video on YouTube, I will provide a link below the video where you can click on this and show you step by step to how to install it. Now, if you click my link that I have here, it will take you to this website here for the 4kdownload.com. It takes a moment to load when you first click on it, because if you're using a Windows operating system, it will show you a little laptop screen with a Windows system screen showing you that it works on Windows. If you got Mac OS, it will show you a Mac OS screen. In this case, I'm using Ubuntu or Ubuntu Mate 18.04.3, the long-term support. So it's showing me Ubuntu, the main distribution, as an example. Now, if you click Get the Slideshow, you'll be able to download, but there's a lot of things that you can view on this web page and see some of the features and that it supports multiple platforms. You just choose to get it. Now, if it's not showing up for the right operating system, or if you're on one operating system you want to download for another, click the drop-down menu and choose your operating system. There's portable versions and there's the installation version, and that's from the website itself. Now, once you install it, this is what the program looks like. It's very simple. Now, if you're using Linux, especially Ubuntu or the Ubuntu derivatives, you'll need JW to run the package installer. If you don't have that, open your terminal and put sudo apt install gdeb. And then once you do, when you download the dev package, just double click it, click the install button, put in your password, wait till it says same version installed before you close out the package installer. Once it installs, it should install into your graphics menu. If it don't, you can reboot. And if it's still not there, you can add it to your graphics menu by putting this into your main menu, launch properties dialog box. Or if you don't like it in the graphics menu, you can change it to for sound and video, since you are making a video format out of your slideshow, out of your images. But like I said, you can open up your main menu, make sure you got it under applications, put 4K Slideshow Maker, put this command. You can just simply copy and paste this, and then click that icon, and this is where you're going to locate the icon that it will install the PNG for it to place that, and then you hit the close and it will place that in the memory. Now, once you load it for the first time, and you won't see this when I load it in just a moment, you will see a little EULA, an end user license agreement, that you'll have to accept in order to use the program. And once you do, this is what the program looks like. You got add photos, add an Instagram, you can add pictures from Instagram, you can add your music, you can show a preview of your slideshow before you see it, and it will be a lower resolution, then you can make your slideshow. Here you've got multiple options as if you press the preferences button up here at the top, and I'll show you all these in just a moment. But if you don't want to watch the rest of the video, you can stop the video and go to my website and I explain all of this. But I will explain my little table that I have here before I start showing you the program itself. When you get to this part of the dialog box, you're going to have multiple video formats. As you can see, it says Windows Standard, Mac OS Standard, iPhone 8, iPhone X Plus, iPad, YouTube Video, Facebook Video, 4K Ultra HD. It don't have the extensions out to the side. Here I added a little table that shows you the video format, the extension that it has, and the aspect ratio that you can have choices. When you see an aspect ratio, it says 16:9 and 4:3, that means you have two choices. You can choose the 16:9 aspect ratio, kind of like the long screens, the newer type monitors and television that support high definition, or the old box type monitors and television for 4:3. So you have choices for your aspect ratios, and some of these you don't. Even though your formats will be the same for the extension, your aspect ratio will be different. So an iPhone 8 will produce an M4V, but the aspect ratio will be different for these. So that's why I created this little chart, then I showed you these little images, and then I actually went through and created a slideshow for each of these, and I left the folder here and took a screenshot where you can look at the images or the extensions for each thumbnail or image that you see in this folder to match it up here. And then I go on to explain each parts of the preferences box, then I show you how to select your files and how to create the slideshow. So all of that is on my website. Now, I won't be adding music. You know, where it comes up here says add music. The reason I don't add music on the video on YouTube is because of copyright violations. But if you do want to see the slideshow with music, I uploaded the one that I made here and put like Silent Night instrumental in the background. Then I uploaded I uploaded my Dropbox and embedded on my webpage. So if you click this button here, you'll see the example of the slideshow that I created. It's only 1:05. So if you click to go to my website, you can click the play button and listen to it as you're watching the images change. You'll see that I do have the Ken Burns effects on here. Now let me show you how to actually use the program. I go to Applications, I go to Graphics, I choose the 4K Slideshow Maker. I did go back to my preferences, and I've learned by using this multiple times, if you clear out the images from your previous slideshow, to clear out your song, you have to say remove music. You know, you remove your photos if they're still on here from the previous one, but don't forget if you've added music that you hit remove music. And I will eventually make some pictures of the menus, but when I do the preferences, you can access them by either the buttons here or the preferences. The first thing I recommend you to do is to click the preferences and choose the settings that you would like to keep as your default. Now, the photo duration, that's the amount of time that you're going to see of the image. This is 6 seconds by default. The transition duration is 1.2 seconds. You can increase the transition time or decrease it, same as increasing the photo time or decrease it. You can say make the slideshow duration equal to the audio length. So if you check that as you're adding images, if you choose an audio file before you make the slideshow, it will calculate how long the song is according to the number of pictures, and it will stretch out your photo duration or shorten your photo duration according to the amount of images. So your slide starts when the music starts, and the last slide will end when the music ends. Now here you can apply the Ken Burns effect, and I recommend to keep that there's some very nice effects during the transition times. You can use face detection technology, so if you're using images of people, that when it's sliding around or moving around, that you're not leaving the faces out of the picture, that they're keeping the faces within the images. Now on my website, you saw I made a table where you can choose the Windows standard, the macOS standard, and all of those that you see here. Now even though this is called 4K Slideshow Maker, you don't have to just to make a 4K slideshow. The reason I say that is because people think when they see the name you're only making 4K. Now if you have an older computer or a device that don't support 4K, I recommend choosing these others. If you got an old computer, it may take a long time just for a small amount of slides to convert your images, upscale it to a 4K scale. So just keep in mind that if you're using an older system, I recommend choosing some of these. And you can look at my information from the website and it'll explain more about that. If you're choosing a format that supports more than one aspect, you can choose your 16:9 or 4.3. I don't have a box screen monitor. I have a high definition monitor that has a 16:9 aspect. And I recommend if your computer supports it and have a stronger processor to choose high quality videos. It may take longer because it will create a larger file, but if you look down here, as I go high, it's 1920 by 1080 H.264 audio codec AAC. If I choose medium, notice the resolution drops from 1080p to 720. If I choose low, it goes from 720 to 480. So your resolution decreases with your quality. So the highest quality is your 1080p, which is high, unless you choose the Ultra 4K Ultra. Notice the sizes, and you don't change it here. It's automatically 3840 by 2160. If your screen resolution can't support that, nor is your television, you don't want to choose that. So I go back to macOS and I choose the high resolution. This is the default folder. If you'd like to choose a different place, click the choose button, change the location, and then when you hit open, it will change this to your default. Now here I got sample slideshow. By default, I think it says my slideshow, but I changed it in the last example where I changed it from my slideshow. I put sample there. So I can, this video here, I might change it to where it says this here. So I have sample-slideshow. If you're making a long slideshow, you probably don't want to sit in front of it to watch as it's converting or creating. So you can choose to play a sound when it's complete so you can hear the ding or the noise it makes when it's finished, so you can come in here to your computer and look at it. You can ask every time before making a slideshow to show this preference box to allow you to give it a different name for each time you create a different slideshow. Now, if you like the new cutting edge technology, you might want to install the beta versions, but they're sometimes buggy and unstable. So if you like to choose something that works, I would choose the standard version that will more than likely produce the best quality. So I wouldn't choose to install the beta version. You can change it, your languages, to a multiple language. I choose the system, which is English. So I'm going to now hit close. I'm going to click add photos, or you can click this plus here. You can go to your pictures folder, and I'm going to go to my Christmas folder. And on my webpage, I showed selecting all of these. For time's sake, I'm only going to select the first four. Then I hit the open button. If you do have an Instagram account, you can click Instagram, put in the username, and then it will start loading your Instagram pictures, and you can select which ones you want to add to the slideshow. The thing I like about this is if I want this video or this image to be the first image in my video, I can just drag it open, and I can change the location. So if I wanted this one second, I could come and put it between second and first, and it makes it my second image. Up here, I can delete an image from the list. So if I added everyone in the folder, I can go through and remove the ones I don't want. You also got extra features here where you can rotate an image clockwise. You can rotate it counterclockwise. You can add more photos, or you can insert photos from the internet, or you can remove a photo or remove all the photos. Here's where you go and add or change your music. We can go like to your music folder and choose like Silent Light that I chose from the example on the internet, but for sake of not getting copyright strikes, I'm going to choose to leave the music off. Now, when you're watching a preview, when you click the preview button, it brings up a little preview window that you can hit the play. Now, the volume's wide open, but there's no sound because I didn't select to play any audio. But as you can see here, I think the default was 6 seconds, so it's going to transition or have a 1.2 transition time between images, and it's going to display the actual image on the screen for 6 seconds. So that's a preview of it. Then if I say make the slideshow, I come up here, and again, you've got the options to change it. You don't have to go to preferences here because it brings up a smaller version of your preferences where you can change your formats if you decide before you burn it. Now, if you uncheck that, it's going to choose the settings that you have in your preferences. But I like to choose ask every time so that you can give it a different name. So if I hit sample slideshow and I hit the continue button, it's going to now create a little bar, status bar at the bottom showing the amount of time, and I'm not going to mess with anything on my computer while it's doing that, because if you can minimize the program here, and you can do things on your computer while it's creating your slideshow. But using your processor power will kind of slow it down. So if you're just letting it do its thing, it will actually complete the process faster. But if you've used computers before and you know that running multiple processes in the background, you know, will slow your system down because it's using power from the processor splitting up to different applications. Now, if you're a power user and got an extremely powerful computer, you can do multiple tasks and it won't slow it down. It won't be that noticeable of processing your or creating your slideshow. It's got approximately between 20 and 10 seconds. It fluctuates the time as it's doing this. It's got a little bit more, and that's why I only chose 4 images instead of the whole folder. And when it's finished, it will give you 3 options: to close, to preview, or to open the folder. And there it played a noise. I don't know if you heard it. It was in my earpiece. I can close the dialog box. I can play the image, or I can show in folder. So if I go show in folder, it's my sample slideshow. That was the slideshow I created when I created my web page. These are the other images that I created earlier from a different computer. And then here is the one that I just created. So if I double click, it's going to play the video. I can stretch it out. I'm not going to adjust the volume because there's no sound to it. But as you can see on my screen, it's clear pictures, it's 1080p. You know, if you've got a low quality image, it's not going to look that great. It's only going to look as good as the picture quality of the images that you're using. So you can't take a mediocre quality image and produce a very high quality definition slideshow from a image that's not that great. But this is one of the easiest slideshow makers, and since it's becoming the holiday season, a lot of you might want to create slideshows. In my opinion, this is one of the easiest ones. In the future, I will show you how some other slideshow makers that will have additional features. And the one drawback I found with using this one is when you say change music or add music, it normally allows you to choose one music file. And that's why the button says change music, because when you go to add another one, it's not going to add another one. If you chose like a 100 or 200 or 1,000 images, one music will play over and over in a loop. And if you don't like that, then you can go to my website. And I say right here, one of the drawbacks is playing one song. If you've got multiple songs, you can click on Audio Joiner, and you can say add your tracks, upload your tracks to this website, and then when you're finished, hit join. That's not to join the website. That's to join the tracks that you've created, and you can join those. Now, with this, there's features that you can choose that you can crossfade between tracks, where, and you can even crossfade at the beginning and end, or you can create your slideshow, see how long it is, and when you're combining your music files, you can cut it off where the slideshow ends, and you can fade at the end of it to make it sound professional. So even though you're only allowed to use one song, you can use this website here to combine all your musics to where you have one song, so that you can name that song as your one song in your folder, so that it matches up with your 4K Slideshow Maker. So that way you can overcome the problem of just choosing one song to create for your slideshow. So that way you can have a longer slideshow with multiple songs. Hopefully this video has helped you understand how to use the 4K Slideshow Maker. And have a good day.